afternoon, and welcome to the Windsor Stars Net News at Noon. I'm Craig Pearson with Don MacArthur, bringing you the best from the paper and the web. Finally, unity. Leaders from Michigan and Canada, including Governor Jennifer Granholm and Mayor Eddie Francis, met today at the Detroit Regional Chamber of Commerce to finally all together express their support for the Detroit River International Crossing Project.
Okay, and speaking of Detroit, it's been named by CNN as one of the most dangerous cities on the planet.
Okay.
You know, not in the country, on the planet. Joining it on the list was Moscow, Cape Town in South Africa, Baghdad, in Iraq, some places in the Congo. Anyway, we're going to have more on this. We've dispatched a reporter and a photographer over there, and we're going to have it for you in Saturday's paper if they make it back alive.
Sales by Canadian manufacturers rose for a fifth month in a row, StatsCan reported this morning, although unfortunately not as much as we would have hoped. It rose only 0.1%.
Anyway, right direction. And folks, coming up later today, the provincial government is going to make an announcement about the health of the Wheatley Harbor, and Jamieson Laboratories is going to announce the reforestation of a historic local landscape. We're going to have these stories and more for you in tomorrow's paper.
Also coming tomorrow is a compelling feature on the troubles rocking the Catholic Church and how it's all affecting the local Catholic community. Some say their faith has been shaken by it, though some say their faith remains strong.
Okay, folks, time now for our photo of the day. This one was sent in to us again. She's a superstar, by Elizabeth Walker. It shows some beautiful flowers there. We're soliciting your spring photos. Send them in to www.windsorstar.com /tips. Will make you famous. And boy, the playoffs began last night. It's been an easy ride so far. We were 8-0, but we got our first real test last night. It was an OT thriller, 7-6. The Rangers down the Spits. Boom. So we'll see how they deal with adversity. They certainly battled back and battled through adversity before. So now it's on to Kitchener for game two. Saturday we're going to be live blogging that game for you at 7 p.m., so make sure you check that out.
Right, and while we're on the topic of excitement, we bring on none other than Julian Revan.
Julian. Hi.
Hey, how are you?
Hi, everybody. I'm really good. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. So,
what's going on?
Well, you're here to tell us that.
Okay. Well, there's a couple of films opening, and both of them have not received good reviews, but I think they're worth mentioning. Death at a Funeral. If any of you are interested in, those Tyler Perry Madea films, I believe that Neil LaBute, the director, is trying to go down those lines. He's trying to appeal to African-American audiences. And Death at a Funeral is actually based on a British flick. It's about family secrets, misplaced bodies, dysfunctional families. And if you're interested in some kind of twisted, you know, Chris Rock, Martin Lawrence.
If you want a bad film,
yeah,
it's for you.
Yeah. But the one I'm really excited about is Kick-Ass. For all you comic book, graphic novel, superhero fans, go check out Kick-Ass. Can I say that on the air?
It's too late now.
That's opening today. Then there's some concerts coming up at the casino, at the Coliseum, Caesars Windsor. The Charlie Daniels Band is performing tonight. Devil Went Down to Georgia, Long-Haired Country Boy. If you're a Southern rock fan, mm-hmm. Go check it out. And then next week is the Gypsy Kings. If you want some progressive, pop-oriented flamenco music, go check out the Gypsy Kings next week at the casino. And speaking of the casino, let's talk about where were you yesterday?
Well, it's funny you should ask. I was at the casino. I was at the Coliseum to hear former U.S. President Bill Clinton speak. And I believe it's the first time he's ever been to town. First president probably here since Jimmy Carter came a few years back for Habitat to Humanity. But anyway, yeah, he was here for the Enviro Expo.
Okay.
Yeah, which is on all weekend at Caesars Windsor. And you can learn all about all things green. But so Bill Clinton came on and he talked about that. He was talking about the need for everybody to pitch in, the need to reduce landfills. One of the things he was on about, reduce energy consumption, move to green energy production, because he says that's where you can not only help the environment, but you can create a lot of jobs.
Okay.
But I have to say, the thing that I found most interesting that he spoke about there was Rwanda.
Okay.
A high school student asked him a question afterward. He spent a good 20 minutes on this. He sounded the most heartfelt of anything that he said, and he reminded how he went to Rwanda afterward and he apologized.
Right.
And he said, Romeo Dallaire was right. That's the Canadian general that headed the UN mission in 1994, and that's when 800,000 Tutsis were killed by Hutus. And He said if we had sent 10 or 20,000 troops, we could have saved 300,000 lives. And he really talked about...
So this is a politician admitting he was wrong.
Yeah. Imagine George Bush going to a country admitting he was wrong somewhere. I don't think it's going to happen. But he honestly felt honest about it and contrite. And I found it really compelling to watch him talk about that.
Hmm. Were there any resolutions? Oh. Sorry.
The resolutions is, you know, we shouldn't allow that to happen in the future. But, of course, I guess that's obvious. But still, it was interesting hearing him talk.
Okay, right. Folks, it depends on what the meaning of is online on your porch. We are the Windsor Star.